Welcome back to my channel. So this is me and my mommy here.
Hi.
We are at the Weddings Extravaganza in Columbus, Georgia, and we're going to go in and see what they have. So y'all follow me through. Look at these tuxedos. All the different tuxedos. Look at my mama. No. Look at that, y'all. Green is nice too. This is what all the other men can wear. That's nice. So I just wanted to tune back in after we left the Bridal Expo. Yes, I look a tad different. Yeah, kind of lipstick really lip gloss on left. But after leaving there, my experience of it was kind of like, So I'm hoping that either Atlanta will have, which I'm pretty sure they will, like within the next few months, because everybody's just getting engaged and married. So I'm pretty sure Atlanta will do another one. So I'm hoping to go to the Atlanta one. And then also there's another one that's supposed to be coming up in Opelika and Opelika and Auburn area. So I'm thinking about taking a trip there and even Montgomery, just to see what these, like, you know, the surrounding areas offer and for how much to get our inexpensive budget wedding. I will say that I seen one dress. I will insert it in here, probably up here somewhere. But I seen one dress that I just like fell in love with. And I'm like, it looks like my dress, my actual wedding dress that I have now. But I'm like, that one's like, it's got a train on it, it's got satin to it, and it's got the pieces of lace that kind of still make you feel elegant and classy, and it's got the chest that I have for my dress. So I don't know, I might check that dress out and see how much it is. Yeah, I'm kicking myself in the butt because I've already bought my dress. But I honestly, like, it wasn't what I thought. It wasn't what I expected. I was hoping for more, as in, like, yes, my babies are back there asleep. I was hoping for more, like, you know, to really see brides and grooms and people playing. I don't know what I thought. Like, maybe playing games, but I think I played, like, the little Plinko. I think it's Plinko. And got 25% off of my husband's tuxedo, which is, that's good, you know. And then I tried some of the food that the venue that hosted the event, we didn't like their little appetizer things that they had. It was kind of gross. And then the venue itself is very nice, which I've been there so many times. I mean, it's, you know, it's a local, you know, it's a local place, but I was hoping to see it more so set up as a wedding. Like, this is what we offer. This is how we can make it look for you, that type of thing. I wanted to see some type of setups and, you know, oh, this is what we do here and this is what we make it look like and we could tailor it to your day. And I think the only thing that I really liked was the Pine Mountain Chalet. How she had her packages like lined up for you that you could see, like, that's what I was looking for. So I liked hers, Pine Mountain Chalet. She had it like her diamond package, or her pretty much as like her most expensive package, but it was everything. So if you want like one done and here, I just pay you and you're done, she had it for you. And she said that you could do different prices. And then also the, I think it's Kimbell's, I liked her food. She had these different meatballs that were very unique, that were not like your average Swedish meatballs or your barbecue meatballs. It wasn't that. It was, I think I had like the pineapple rum meatball or something like that. And it was so good with the little sauce on it. And then she had your lobster and crab macaroni and cheese. And then she had the different macaroni and cheese, like four cheese with spice in it. Then you had your mac and cheese with ham in it. It's just like the different little things. I got to see the limo. It just was not what I really thought it was going to be like. I think I went to one before with a friend that they gave us a ride in the limo to go to look at one of the venues, like one of the houses that hosts weddings here in town. Somebody gave away, you know, like some money off of your wedding dress, and they had those little drawings, but there wasn't very many people there, and you had to be present to win. There wasn't very many people there, and it was just kind of like, y'all really aren't giving anything away. And then the dresses I got, they had a fashion show of some bridal gowns, and I think it was like a total of maybe 6 or 7 bridal gowns, and you had your bridesmaids. I seen a bridesmaid dress that I really like because it's more, because if we do the beach wedding, you got your, it's very flowy and it's chiffon. And then if you do, even if you did an inside wedding or a wedding here, it's still like, it's light. I like the chiffon look of it versus formal. Even though my wedding will be semi-formal, I like the flowy, like easy look of it. So, but I was just hoping to see more, excuse me, I was hoping to see more. I didn't see what I thought I was going to see, but it was kind of like a great start, and it got me excited. As you see my little glowing headband, I'm so excited about this, but it got me started and a little bit more excited into what I'm going to be looking for and doing for our big day. Our big day has now been pushed back. Technically, it would be like another year. So it's one more year. So we're now in the year 2020. So this is the year that we start paying for stuff for our wedding in 2021. I'm not a person who, I really would have liked to did it, you know, like all in the same, like, oh, within this next year. But funds and budget, you know, like I'm a person who I like to do my stuff in advance and make sure everything is taken care of. I'm not going to stress about it. It's not going to hurt my pocket so much, and it's not going to take from my children, you know, they got to be fed first. It's not going to take away from me and my husband doing whatever we need to do, or even just enjoying being married or being engaged. That's a big part. I don't want any of that stuff to take away from it. So I feel like me pushing the wedding back, our ceremony date back a little bit further, it helps. It helps that, because like a lady said today, she said, how long have you been engaged? And I said, technically I'm already married, but like we didn't get a chance to be engaged except for like a week or two. I said, but I've been married. We've been married for 3 months, y'all. So I'm so excited. But, and she said, you have this glow of you. And I said, thank you. And I've heard that a lot. And I think it's because we're really enjoying this time, and we're really getting to know, like, not that we don't know each other, but you know, you're like, you're getting to know each other in this new space, this new time. We're trying different things. Just we're being each other's peace. And I think it's really showing because I'm enjoying myself. I love him so much. Like, I'm just enjoying it, you guys. And being married, it's very trying, but it's so awesome and it's so beautiful because you have this person and you're just like, I can't give up on you. I won't give up on you. And he is my, you know, he's my best friend, but we just like, we've been enjoying each other and I love it. I love it. I'm so excited for our day, like to get to say our vows, you know, to each other, whatever. I'm sure you guys have heard me say that a million times, but I'm just so excited to see him dressed up. I love seeing him like dressed up and smiling, and maybe I love to dress up. I'm like one of them people, dress up, y'all. Let's put on some makeup. Let's put on our good clothes. Probably because I spend so much time in work clothes, like, and in so much time in work clothes and, you know, like your everyday clothes. I don't really get to dress up like that. So the fact that I get to dress up, and we're starting on our new year, we're starting date nights 2 times a month. So I'm excited to see how that even enhances our relationship a little bit more. Because, you know, we got these two crazies back here. Yes, they're passed out. So we got those two crazies. So, you know, time away and time getting to know each other again. And, you know, just looking into our eyes. Me looking into his eyes. It just feels good, and I can't wait. We took the time to go out this past week for our first time as being like in a couple setting and being with other couples and being without the kids, and we went in our new year as a married couple. Like, it's just been awesome. So I just wanted to share this with you guys, and y'all tell me what y'all think about this little wedding expo. I didn't really like it too much, but hey, it is what it is. We're going to go with it, and I really do plan on vlogging the next one. This one I didn't vlog it because it was like, there's nothing. What is there to see? And plus, I need to see it too. So, so I will let you guys see the next one when we do it, and if we go, if there is even another one, I don't know. Whatever the case may be. I'm going to keep you guys updated, and thank you guys for coming along, and thank you guys for tuning in. Don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, and even comment. Tell me your opinion, and how was your time of planning a wedding, and also how was the bridal shows when you went? Was it fun? Did you see something, or was it kind of just like, tell me your experience in the comment section below. Thank you guys for tuning in. Over and out. Love y'all. Bye.